Welcome everybody to the series marked by its history. In this third sequence, we will talk about the Stirling formula, which involves factorial n. To do so, we will consider the function, the logarithm function here, and we will subdivide the interval 1n into interval, and we write the following. Log factorial n, it simply equals sigma ln g plus 1 g equals 1 to n minus 1. Where here ln g plus 1 interpreted in terms of the area, we can write this area eg. This area between the two lines g x equals g and x equals g plus 1. Okay. To do this clearly, we have this rectangle here to add some explanation. Now we have the area AG. The area AG, it's equals to top triangle red, which equals TG, plus the trapez OG. But this TG, OG here, it's equals the area under the curve, say g plus 1 ln t dt minus this overlapping will be noted epsilon g minus epsilon g. Okay. The above we obtain this, and now we integrate the part, we obtain n plus n ln n minus n plus 1 minus sigma epsilon g to n minus 1. Now this is, we take exponential for the two members of the equality, we obtain factorial n equals square n, and here n, and here e minus n, and here e 1 minus sigma epsilon g1 to n minus 1. Now I will convert this to into a series. We obtain square root of n over e n exponential 1 minus the series g1 to infinity epsilon g, okay, times exponential the remainder epsilon g equals n to infinity. Note please that we have an equality. So now it will to be proved that this series is convergent. So these terms will be 10 to 1. Now our equality have this form with Rn is the remainder which equals epsilon g to n to infinity. Now we want to prove the convergence of this series, so we will call that epsilon g equals g plus 1 half times log 1 plus 1 over g minus 1. We know the expansion of this expression, which is equals to minus n minus 1 over gn to infinity. Applying this expansion here by factoring and constant 1, we obtain the following. It's simply equals minus n minus 1 here to n plus 1 gn. to infinity. That's all. But from the alternate series, this with some epsilon g, we know that epsilon g is between two values, two following values. Finite values, if we want, sigma not this term is an, this is an, we have this is between an n1 to say grand n minus 1, and the second value will be n. Then we did use that, so epsilon g, we may deduce easily that epsilon g may be equals, will be equals 1 over plus little o 1 over g squared. Equality epsilon g equals 1 over 12 g squared plus little o g squared, we deduce that this series, the series epsilon g, is finite convergent series. So now we return to the formula factorial n equals square root n times n over e n, and the exponential 1 minus sigma, the convergent series, times exponential rn. We deduce also that limit rn when n tend to infinity is equals to 1. So now we take denote by c the constant exponential 1 minus sigma epsilon g to infinity. We conclude that our exact result now is factorial n equals to square root n, n over e power n times c times exponential rn, which this tend to 1. Here, excuse me, here rn tend to 0, and so exponential rn tend to 1. Now in the in the future step, we must calculate exactly the constant c. So it is a first approach of the forward Stirling formula, which says exactly that its asymptotic value is square 2 pi n, n over e, n, well, the constant is square root of 2 pi. Okay. We finish this sequence by the following observation. Here c is equals exponential 1 minus the series to infinity. But this series epsilon g, it's equals infinity to double series minus 1 n minus 1 to n n plus 1 g n. Now we can reverse the summation to find in another form, more easy, minus 1 n, n minus 1 over 2 n, n plus 1, and here zeta Riemann, zeta n, n equals 1 to infinity. Now My problem is to find the value of this double series and then conclude Stirling formula. Thank you very much for watching and see you to the next video.